wallahi tallahi banda mu kare duka akan ataba annabi mun shiru ya kamata ku sani akwai.
This is Christianah Oluwasesin. She was lynched by secondary school students in Gombe in 2007, who accused her of desecrating the Quran while invigilating an exam. In this video, we will be uncovering how a simple act of misunderstanding and religious extremism led to ending the life of a woman in the peak of her career. Christianah was more than a teacher. She was a beacon of hope in a community bridging the gap between different faiths and beliefs. But in 2007, a misunderstanding led to a horrific event that would forever change the lives of many. In just a few moments, we will reveal the shocking details of this event and its aftermath, which are as important as they are heart-wrenching. But first, let's understand who Christianah was and why her story is so crucial today. Christianah Oluwatoyin Oluwasesin was a teacher of government subjects in a government secondary school of Gandu in the northern Nigerian state of Gombe. She was a married mother of two and had already served state authorities notice of her resignation to join her husband, Femi, in their hometown of Abeokuta, where he had taken up a job as a laboratory technician at a hospital. She was glad that she would soon be with her husband after the final day of exams. On that fateful day, Oluwasesin was supervising a class, writing a final examination on Islamic religious knowledge, and to prevent cheating and other forms of examination malpractices, she collected books, papers, and bags before the exam began in the all-female class and dropped them in front of the class. Soon after, the bags collected by Oluwasesin were dropped in front of the class. One of the girls in the class began to cry. She told her fellow students that she had a copy of the Quran in her bag, that Oluwasesin touched the bag, and that by doing so, she had desecrated the Quran since she was a Christian. Right after, students in the class began shouting, "Allahu Akbar," meaning God is great. Yila, one of the teachers, alerted staff members in the school, who rushed to the scene to try and bring calm. In the process, Yila was able to take Oluwasesin out of the class to the office of the principal. The principal left Oluwasesin in his office and also went out to calm down the Muslim students. He then went back to the scene and was shocked to find that outside Muslim extremists had joined the chaos, destroying school property and demanding that Oluwasesin be given to them to be stoned to death. The mob believed that she had torn up a copy of the Quran, a book considered holy to over a billion people, and it's a sin. In the principal and staff members' attempt to prevent handing Oluwasesin to them, they started stoning the principal and the staff, and few others broke into the principal's office and dragged her out. The principal rushed there to save her as they clubbed her with an iron on the head, and blood was gushing out from the wounded side of the head. He was pleading that they should not kill her, but they were insisting that she must be killed. The principal succeeded in getting Oluwasesin up to the school gate. There was a house near the gate, and he dragged her into the house, but the rioting Muslims went into the house and dragged her out again. This time, they clubbed her to death, brought old mats and placed dirt on her corpse, and then burned the body. The students went ahead to set fire to classrooms, the library, Oluwasesin's car, and the motorcycle of Yila, who had then fled the scene. Fire personnel at the time said they could not get to the area as all roads leading to the school, which had a student population of about 4,000 with about 10% being Christian, were blocked. After the incident, 16 suspects were arrested but were released without charge. Following the murder of his beloved wife, Oluwasesin's husband, Femi, and the children headed to court, demanding that the state government accept liability and compensate the family for the death of his wife. Femi began receiving death threats from anonymous callers in 2010, ordering him to withdraw the case he instituted against the state government. In all of these, what baffles many is the fact that throughout the chaos that killed Oluwasesin, a copy of the Quran, which was said to have been desecrated, was never seen. Whether the Quran was in the bag of that student, Nobody knows, Yila said in an interview following the gruesome murder of Oluwasesin. Christianah's story is a powerful reminder of the work that lies ahead of us as we strive to building a Nigeria that reflects the aspirations of our founding fathers, as well as a nation our children will be proud of. Please note, the aim of this video is not to stir any form of hatred in you, but to remind you of how important tolerance and restraint is in building a peaceful community for all. In the comments below, let us know how stories like Christianah's influence your perspective on tolerance and unity. For more stories that challenge, inspire, and call for change, don't forget to subscribe and like this video to join our community. Together, we can make a difference. Thank you for staying with us till the end.